Hello, my name's Nancy. In this tutorial, I'll show you an example of using the REST API and PHP code to access Oracle Service Cloud from a web page. Here I have a little demo application, a form on a page, which is hosted here on my local machine, but of course, it could be hosted on any server anywhere. You can see that what I'm doing here is having the user enter a first and last name of a contact, and then returning the ID for that contact. You could then use that ID to retrieve other data about the contact or to delete it, for example. We're going to look at the code behind this, and let me remind you that this is just a demo. It's deliberately simplified, so there are elements missing and the approach to security is pretty casual. In other words, this is not code that you should copy and use in production. With that said, let me show you that first here I have HTML to create the form, and two text input boxes named fname and lname. And then we get into the PHP. I'll get the values of the first and last name from the form and use them to create this URL that uses a query to locate the contact by first and last name. There's a little possible gotcha here that I want to point out. See where I put these %20s here? Those are symbols for a space. Spaces are required around the logical operator and if you use it in a query in the REST API, but spaces aren't allowed in an HTTP URL. So I'm using this percent encoding, where %20 represents a space, to get around that. Now I'll load the curl library, which is one way to send HTTP requests in PHP. I'll do a little setup here, like telling curl to return the response is a string without the response header. And then here I'll set up the appropriate HTTP verb, which is get, because I'm just fetching data. This next line sidesteps some of the normal security. And remember, I'm taking some shortcuts here because this is just a demo app. And then here is where I make the call to the server. And the returned value will be put here into a variable named response. I'll catch any errors in the call, like network errors, for example, and then I'll also print any curl error that pops up, like being unable to resolve the server, before I close the curl connection. The response from a REST API call is encoded in JSON, so I'm using the JSON decode function to parse it out and store it in a variable named info. Now I can check to see if the response included an HTML status, which it will if there was an error. So if the status is set, I'll print out what that was. Here, I'm just printing out the entire response so I can see it. And then finally here, I'll use that info object to get the data I want, which is the ID in the first item, and in this case, the only item, that's in the returned response, which is an array of items. Now back to the browser and let's run this. Here's a first and a last name, Bob Hart. And when I click get, you can see the full response here, and then the parsed out ID here. This is just to show you that you could extract any piece of data you wanted from the response. Thanks for watching.